What's going on, everybody? It's Eric Ray with the back here, and I'm about to show you the best defense in Madden 21. Now, I know I haven't really been doing a lot of tips this year. The game kind of sucks. A lot of people aren't enjoying it as much, but I did want to come back and hit you guys with something new. For those of you that are playing and still struggling with defense, we're going to look at the nickel 3-3-5 wide. And the one main key here is you want to make sure your outside linebackers, we have Bowser here and Patrick Queen, you want those to be fast guys, because this is going to be a little two-play kind of mini defensive scheme. I'm going to show you a coverage defense and then how to blitz out of it. And it's really hard to blitz this year. There's not a lot of blitzes that work, so this is one of the best, if not the best, blitz in the game. So the play we're going to look at is the Mike Blitz Zero. We're going to use this for everything. Now, this is actually taken from huddle.gg, which is a website that I work with every year. They have the best advanced Madden strategy on the planet. This was taken from one of their game plans. They've allowed me to share it with you guys. Now, if you want to unlock the whole game plan outside of the two plays I'm going to show you here, there's a ton more stuff that goes with this. The link will be below. It does help give a little bit of a kickback to the channel if you want to help support the channel, but I did want to make sure to let you guys know that. So first, I'm going to look at the coverage defense, which is going to be a man style coverage defense. What we're going to do first is we're going to blitz all of our linebackers. So that is right on the D-pad and then down on the right stick. And they're already blitzing, but when we globally blitz them like that, it's going to help us with the next step, which is we want to press the defense until this middle linebacker comes into the gap. So to press your defense, it's wire triangle and then down on the left stick. Now notice everybody pressed, but this guy didn't move. So you want to just keep doing that over and over, and you see then he eventually moves into the gap just like that. So you press Y down, Y down, Y down, just over and over until he comes into the gap. Usually on the second, third try, he's going to go right there. You want to take your strong safety, kind of just move him over a little bit. It's just better to have him lined up a little bit more with this leverage. It's not necessary, but that's how they run it. And then what you want to do, you get on the outside linebacker here. You want to put him into a curl flat, which is A or X, depending on your system, and then right on the left stick. And then you can just hit the B or circle button. It brings you right to your middle linebacker. Press A or X. Up on the left stick, put him in a middle third, and then jump right over here to this outside linebacker. Same thing, A or X, right on the left stick. We got the two purples. We got this deep zone, but because he's hovering here in the gap, it allows him to drop into a perfect spot over the middle where it's hard to beat him with like post routes or like crossing routes over the middle. He just gets in a really good area to defend it. And then we're just going to use this guy right here, this safety. The bunch formation on offense is typically what you're going to see if someone's passing the ball. And this is the coverage style defense. And you're going to still get pretty decent pass rush typically, but you just kind of want to hang around over the middle. And you see there's nothing open. It's all locked up. And as you can see, pass rush with this formation actually gets home pretty quickly. Now, I'm going to have the setups and all that in the description for both of these plays. I'm going to show you the blitz in a minute, but I will have the setups there just, so you guys, in case you forget it, because it's going to take a little bit to learn it. So again, let's just show you how quick you can set it up. So again, globally blitz linebackers, press, kind of get them over there. And you can see we're set up, I didn't move this guy over. It's not 100% necessary, but if you have time, it's good to do it. Another optional thing that is smart to do if you have time is to shade your coverage over the top. Like after you press them and all this and get your setup, you want to press Y or triangle and then up on the right stick. That's going to make it to where the receivers don't get bumped. The defensive backs are going to bail. And the only reason this is smart to do is because, like, let's say the guy on the outside, the X receiver, sometimes he might just win directly off the press and just get behind him, and there's nobody over top to defend him. So it is good to shade over top. It does prevent you from getting just beat right off the line. And again, you can see, we're usering, nothing really open here. And again, good block sheds out of this. So this is, you could literally just run this coverage style defense the majority of the game and you'll be good. Again, one more time, we'll show it and then we'll get into the blitz. But it's just a really, really solid defense. It's hard for anything to come open because man defense is so good this year. Also note with the curl flats, you can adjust those in your coaching adjustments that we've talked about before on this channel. Right now we have them set to default, but you can set them to 20 yards, 25 yards, which is something I do. It just depends on the down and distance. If it's like a third and 15, I might drop them 15, 20 yards if I think they're going to try to beat me to the sideline with like a corner or a crossing route. But you can just leave them default a lot of the time as well. I mean, look, again, you see how good the block shed is, and just there's nothing open. But you always want to just be mindful that you can adjust your curl flats. Now, also, if you're enjoying this content and you want to always be up to date on tips like this or Madden news, make sure to subscribe, turn on the bell icon so that you don't miss these uploads when I do post them and they go live. So now let's get into the blitz. Now, Blitz is going to be very similar. We're going to globally blitz all linebackers right on the D-pad, down on the right stick. We're going to continually press over and over until they come into the gap. Right, again, we move this guy over is ideal if you can. And then this is pretty much the blitz setup. The only other thing we have to do is we want to blitz this guy that we're using, and we want to make sure we kind of get in that same area on the gap. This is what's really key here. So if the running back goes out, we're going to take him. We're going to let our blitzing guy, we're going to let the computer kind of take him a step or two forward. Like, we're going to let him kind of come down like this, and then we're going to bail out. And you're going to see what I mean here. And if they're not blocking anybody, you're going to get both of these linebackers clean off the edge, and they're going to come really fast. So watch what I mean. I let him take a few steps. Now I shoot out here to the flat, and I'm going to get the running back there. That's my responsibility now. So you can see here on the replay, we take a couple steps forward with our user. We let the blitz take over him, and then we bail out, and we're here. Now nothing's open, and you see we got two guys coming free off the edge. Now unfortunately here, the guy on the right, Patrick Queen, he did get nano detected, and that's why he stopped. But it's fine, because usually that doesn't happen. But even still, we got Bowser here on the left, and he's coming in free. And look, even these guys in the middle are just like instantly shedding. It's just a really kind of glitchy formation this year. But you see, there's nothing open right here. Most of these guys haven't even broken on their route yet, and we're already to the QB. Now, this is very similar to like a Madden 20 style defense, where you were getting that dual, you know, that dual heat off the edge. But you had to blitz seven people in Madden 20 to do that. Here, we're only blitzing, we're technically blitzing seven, but we're bailing out in the coverage. So it's really like we're only blitzing six. So again, you see what I mean here? We're out there to cover the running back, and you see two guys free. It's absolutely ridiculous, and they're just in the backfield. And the really key thing about this is because we're playing coverage defense the majority of the time, which I would say like 70, 80% of the time, most people are not going to block their running back. They're going to be sending multiple people out because they have to, because we're dropping so many people back every single play. So when we do come on the blitz, you know, they don't have any reason to think that they need to block the running back. And then we're just out here. That time, something kind of goofed and we only got one guy in. But that's fine. Even if you only get one guy in, you're fine, because most people are never going to be blocking you, because they're just not expecting you to ever blitz. So you want to mix the blitz in like on a third down here, there. But the coverage defense works so well because man is so good in Madden 21 that you don't need to blitz that often. And when you do pull it out, they're just not ready for it at all. And you got a guy coming in completely free. Usually you're going to have two guys coming in free every single time. And if they do block the running back, then what you do when you see the running back block, you just allow your blitzer, your user, to just blitz down, because then it becomes a numbers game. They have five guys blocked. Right, or six guys blocked rather, and you're blitzing seven, because instead of dropping him back into coverage, you're just going to keep rushing down right at this left tackle. So you're still going to get one guy in free, and they should get there quick enough for your man coverage to hold up. So that's the little two-play mini scheme. Again, you can get the whole game plan on huddle.gg. my link is below in the pinned comment. It does help support the channel. Hope you enjoyed this video and found it helpful. If you did, as always, like, comment, subscribe, and I will see you guys next time.